Good morning, Elephant Money Community. Today is Wednesday, July 3rd. My name is Aaron, and this is your market update. Let's get on into Bitcoin. Bitcoin is going through some drama right now with the Mt. Gox. $9 billion worth of Bitcoin could be dumped onto the market, is being given back from decades worth of court cases to the original investors. And nearly all of it is in profit for these people, as it has been wrapped up for an entire decade, guys. So a lot of people think it's rather likely that these $9 billion worth of Bitcoin could be dumped into the market. It seems like none of that Bitcoin has actually been giving back to investors, but people are front running the possibility. So there is definitely some FUD in the chart, especially since we bounced just a couple days ago and are heading back down. We could come back down to the support range about $58,000. If that does not hold up, I do think 57 is a very strong support. But also, there's a lot of people talking about a possibility of going all the way back down to about $50,000 before resuming the bull market. And I do think that's possible based on previous markets, guys. We have come up a massive amount. I mean, there's a 88% up right here. I do think a 30% correction, like we've seen in other markets, is absolutely possible. And getting down to $50,000 would actually be a 30% drop for Bitcoin, which in previous markets has been rather healthy. If you look back at the last cycle, guys, there's a 30% move right here. And if you look pre-halving last year, we had this run-up pre-halving. This was similar to the run-up pre-halving that we had this cycle. And look at this, from here to here, there's a 32% drawdown. And from here down to here, there's about a 34% drop down. So these are absolutely possible, even in pre-bull markets. So looking back at the current price, guys, I do think a 30% drop in Bitcoin is possible, though unlikely, especially because of the ETFs. Let's get into Ethereum, guys. We have dropped down in Ethereum as well. We're currently sitting at $3,300. I do think a bounce point could be around $3,100 to $3,200 if we get all the way down there. If we break through that, guys, resistance looks pretty strong around $2,850. But the ETH ETF news, which we did get more of and some more clarity in general, guys, it looks like mid-July will be the opening of the ETFs. We got a message from the SEC asking for refiling of the S1s due the July 8th. So potential final deadlines for updated S1s could be July 12th, with a theoretical launch of the week of the 15th of July. So I'm personally expecting to see the ETFs launch around the 15th, though even Gary Gensler said it could be as late as August or September, guys. I'm more bullish than certainly he is. Until we get the ETFs, guys, I do think Ethereum will trade in lockstep with Bitcoin. So if Bitcoin goes down, so will Ethereum, and maybe even a little stronger. As soon as these ETFs do get started, guys, I do think we'll see massive adoption, as Ethereum has the most viable revenue mechanism in the entire space. Moving on into Binance, we did see a dip just like we did in the other ecosystems, guys. So though money flow is still continuing up on this, I do expect this to hold around $520. And if it gets all the way down to $520, guys, I do expect a violent jump to the upside from there. Solana keeps bouncing off what was support and now resistance, guys. I do expect this to be resistance until we see it break out in Bitcoin. The Solana price again should hold up around 120 bucks if it does come down that far this time. Again, this is very similar to the rest of the market, guys, though it seems like Solana is fighting a harder battle to the upside. Now let's get into the Elephant Money ecosystem, and Trunk is the token to be in, guys. Though it's very interesting to see the difference between what's going on in the Binance Smart Chain and on Solana. On the Binance chain right now, we have a price of 83 cents per Trunk, and on Solana, guys, it's all the way up at 88 cents. So this is an opportunity to take advantage of lower prices on the BNB chain and then bridge it over to the Solana chain. Now, I don't recommend that you sell it on Solana. However, the value is higher over there, and it may continue to be, especially as we have a lot of older holders of the Trunk token back when it was in Stampede on the Binance Smart Chain, which are holding it since it was a stable coin at a dollar. So as I've been saying, guys, there's been a lot of turbulence around this 60 cents all the way up to about 85 cents. I do think the hardest battle has already been won getting through this turbulence here, but we could see some major resistance around a dollar before getting into price discovery. So keep rowing in the same direction, herd, buy up some trunk, use the Solend pool to either leverage that position or help us with that business side of things by lending or borrowing some USDC, and hang on for the ride. Make sure to zoom out, guys, and remember that trunk has a fixed supply, is deflationary, and is getting eaten up constantly by futures deposits. So the sky is the limit after a dollar. Make sure to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell for more content just like this. We'll see you again Friday morning. Have a great day, and God bless.